Sometimes when you're looking at gaming news, whether it be online or in a magazine, you'll hear about titles releasing soon that look interesting to you, but ultimately, for one reason or another, you forget about them and you forget to play them, and their existence simply slips from your mind. And that's what we're all about with the Forgotten Franchise, video gaming franchises that have been forgotten or lost to time. And today we'll be taking a look at one of these franchises that I personally forgot about, the Darkness series. Let's get started. Mark Silvestri, Garth Ennis, and David Wohl have decades of comic book editing, writing, and experience between them, working on high-profile franchises including Wolverine, The Boys, and Witchblade. However, one of their more interesting works came out in 1996, published by Top Cow Productions, which was also founded by Mark, titled The Darkness. The Darkness featured a man named Jackie Estacado, a hitman for the Franchetti family. When Jackie is betrayed by the Franchetti family and is killed in a fiery explosion after a brief visit to hell, he is reincarnated by a spirit simply known as the Darkness. Whoever possesses the Darkness is given the ability to pull demonic creatures out of another dimension known as Darklings to do their bidding. By 2005, the Darkness comic book series had become very popular. So popular that Majesco Entertainment swooped up the rights to make a video game adaptation of the popular series. Unfortunately, Majesco was having some serious financial trouble around this time and decided to primarily focus on easy, cheap-to-produce titles. The CEO of Majesco at the time was quoted saying the following, "This has been a difficult year for Majesco. We entered the premium console market with high expectations for success, but as a result of a variety of factors, we have not been able to meet our expectations. Recently, we evaluated our product portfolio and have sold or canceled most of our premium console titles that were scheduled for release in 2006 and beyond. But one company's failures is another company's opportunity, and 2K Games swooped in and picked up the rights for The Darkness. But all this shuffling around might not have been as consequential as one would think, as Starbreeze Studios worked on the game the entire time, both under Majesco and under 2K Games. Starbreeze Studio up until this point hadn't really worked on anything incredibly massive or ambitious, but had the Chronicles of Riddick: Escape from Butcher Bay under their belt, so while the studio was still fairly young, they had one game that received incredibly positive reviews and is widely regarded as one of the best games of that generation. In anticipation for the release of the Darkness video game, a comic book miniseries was released, titled The Darkness, Level 1-5, which closely followed the plot of the game. So now that we have a good backstory, let's take a look at the game itself. The plot of the Darkness video game closely resembles the plot of the original comic book series, where you play as Jackie Estacado, a hitman for the mob, only this time we are dropped straight into having the Darkness powers and don't have to worry about any of that pesky exposition. This was a great move by Starbreeze Studios, allowing the player to get to experience some of the Darkness's abilities right off the bat, and there are some really cool abilities, such as being able to spawn in one of four different Darklings to attack your foes. You can also disconnect one of the Darkness's heads from Jackie's bodies and have it sliver around the map like a very angry centipede, attacking enemies and unlocking doors. However, while we do get to experience the Darkness's abilities, they are rather limited in the beginning of the game. As mentioned, you can only spawn one Darkness type called the Kamikaze, and it isn't super effective. And the Angry Centipede, while cool and can help you reach areas Jackie can't fit, it's not really all that helpful. For the most part, the first 2 hours or so of this game is spent like a typical first-person shooter, just blasting away at enemies with rather boring weaponry. This also leads to one of the more frustrating aspects of the games. Because being in the Darkness is advantageous to the player, you often find yourself shooting out light bulbs. This game's programming tries to make it a bit easier by helping you lock on the light bulbs, but doesn't seem to function all that well, and at times can make it hard to move from enemy to enemy in combat. Enemies also seem to be bullet sponges, taking multiple shots to bring down and even sometimes appearing to resurrect themselves and getting back up to shoot you. The Darkness follows the trend of overly edgy first-person shooters in the early to mid-2000s. I like to refer to three games as the Edgelord Trilogy. Those games are Fear, The Darkness, and Condemned. I mean, just look how similar these games look. If you had absolutely no context to any of these franchises and didn't know any better, you probably would all think that these games were in the same universe. And if I showed you my board that I've been working on connecting all three of these games, you wouldn't think that was crazy, right? Yeah, no, I didn't think so. Anyway, as other reviewers have mentioned, the environments this game contains are actually really impressive for the year it came out. Yes, all of them are rather brooding and dark, but they also feel very alive with an impressive amount of detail. The ability to interact with NPCs and have full-on conversations with them is there, You could also go into a good deal of exploration with hidden areas that have collectibles. Then there are also payphones that you can use to call numbers that you can find throughout the game, leading to interesting conversations. But the game also does a really good job of mixing up its environments. It doesn't take place exclusively in dark and sketchy alleys. For a good portion of the game, you're transported to Hell, which takes the shape of a World War I battlefield where you learn the origin of the darkness and obtain the darkness weapons. Let's circle back to the darkness itself, as it's by far the single most interesting part of this game. You see, it's more than just two venom-like tentacles that give you special abilities. It has a personality all of its own, and will even interact with Jackie. Although usually to put him down or control his actions, as it sets up a dynamic between Jackie and itself that can only really be compared to Eddie Brock and Venom. I'm not going to dive too much deeper into the game's plot, as it's actually pretty solid and I don't want to spoil anything. But by the time you've come back from Hell, you should be pretty powerful and you've had time to devour tons and tons of hearts from your victims. Devour hearts, you ask? Well, in order to upgrade and use the darkness to its fullest strength and abilities, you need to eat the hearts of the enemies that you kill. At first, devouring hearts is really cool as it's super gory, but it soon becomes rather cumbersome as it's not really all that fluid and it does slow down gameplay. But let's revisit the darkness as a tool of destruction now that he's a bit stronger. You still have all the same powers as before, but now with the ability to use one of your darkness's tentacles as a weapon to bash enemies in certain parts of the environment. You can also now spawn three other types of darklings that all have their own special abilities. One darkling will run up to enemy types and simply explode, another holds a machine gun and will blast away enemies in your environment, albeit a little inaccurately, then another will seek out lights in your environment and destroy them. But why would you want the world around you to be darker? Well, as the name of the darkness implies, this game requires you to use the darkness to your advantage. If you're caught in a bright light, you will be unable to use your abilities and will be more susceptible to taking damage. One criticism that I do have though is that it's very difficult to tell what around your environment is considered light that can affect the darkness. Obviously something like a street lamp or a lamp on a wall will nullify your darkness abilities, but I often caught myself wondering if just the game's dull ambient lighting was enough to affect my abilities, and the game was often unsure as well. The same inconsistency can also be seen in the overall tone of the game. For the most part, it takes itself very seriously, with giving us a very deep and dark plot, a protagonist that while friendly is also very serious and intense, and an environment that, as mentioned, is very dark and brooding. But then the game also throws in a bunch of cool hats on some demons and go, yeah, this totally fits. But this just goes to show that there can be a stark difference between what is acceptable in some mediums versus others. This kind of thing fits very well in the comic book world, but makes much less sense in a movie or a video game. Speaking of the main character, we're also given a bunch of these loading screens where Jackie gives us a brief overview of what he's thinking. I get that these are supposed to be serious and intense, but they come off as edgy and pretty underacted. The scenes all give the vibe of a high school kid who thinks he's a rough and tough bad guy. The darkness also came with its very own multiplayer mode. Players fight on several large scale and open maps as humans, but the humans are able to shift into darklings at a moment's notice. This provides a really interesting sense of speed to the multiplayer experience, and it's unlike anything I've ever really played before. After the darkness' success, 2K ordered a sequel to begin production immediately, but they decided they wanted to switch up developers, tapping Digital Extremes for development. Around that time, 2K had Digital Extremes working on a few very high-profile projects, such as the PS3 port of the original Bioshock and the Bioshock 2 multiplayer, but the studio also had experience developing games that were very similar in tone, such as Dark Sector, so it makes sense as to why 2K decided to move forward with the up-and-coming studio. The Darkness 2 starts off with a literal bang, where Jackie is attacked by a raveling mob and is forced to use the darkness even though he has been keeping it hidden deep down for years. Once the action dies down, you'll notice two extreme changes from the first game. First of all, the art style has received a massive overhaul. The brooding atmosphere is completely gone, and in its place is a much more fitting comic booky style, which makes a lot more sense with the overall context of the game. The second thing you'll notice is just how much stronger the darkness feels and is in this game. In the first game, the darkness felt like a weapon that you had to manage and were never 100% sure that was going to work properly. In the Darkness 2, the darkness feels like a much more natural extension of Jackie and is able to do some really awesome things that were not possible in the first game. Some of my personal favorites are the ability to pick up objects around the environment and use them as weapons, but also being able to pick up enemies and execute really gory and satisfying kills, and being able to eat hearts on the fly. The new abilities and the overall fluidity of the darkness match very well with the game's narrative, where Jackie is much more in tune with the darkness and a deeper resentment and understanding of it. Jackie is also a lot more fleshed out and thankfully a whole heck of a lot less one note than he was in the original game. The loading screens that were overly edgy and yet very boring in the first game are now a lot cooler cooler and much more entertaining. A big reason for Jackie's shift is that Digital Extremes decided to go with a new voice actor for Jackie in Brian Bloom. There are more improvements in the gameplay department as well. You now have the ability to upgrade the darkness with several different skill trees, something that the original game lacked entirely. Well, I take that back. The original game did have a skill tree, but it only went in one direction, and that direction was a straight line. While The Darkness 2 has a lot of exciting improvements, there are some things that are very similar to the original game, including major plot beats. Both games, the loss of a loved one occurs at about around 3 hours or so. The Darkness 2's storyline is also held back a bit by the original not establishing strong relationships between the characters like the sequel tries to. It's tough to feel strongly towards a character when you've only exchanged a few tidbits with them. The enemies in the game also tend to be rather one-dimensional, just bad guys who are shooting at you. However, they do attempt to use light around you in order to limit your darkness abilities. There are many times where you'll have to shoot out a light a bad guy is carrying, or shoot out a generator so that you can navigate your environment more easily. It's also way more clear as to what qualifies as light in this sequel. The only aspect of this game that I'm torn on is how the Darklings are treated much differently than they were in the original game. You can no longer spawn in Darklings on a whim. Instead, you are only given one Darkling who acts more as your sidekick, who is able to do his own thing in battle rather than you ordering him around. But I feel like he doesn't really need them as he does a good job in combat. Also, you can throw him at enemies, which is incredibly entertaining. But I do miss the different abilities the original Darklings had, and I wish I could at least upgrade my Darkling to have different strengths in this game. One of the biggest improvements this game has that a lot of people fail to mention is that it moves at a much more exciting pace than the original game did. The original game had an open world. The Darkness 2 does not have this. I think in gaming today, most people would view this as a negative thing, but I don't. While the original Darkness world was rather pleasing to look at, it really only served as a needless buffer between missions. I even had a really hard time figuring out where I was supposed to be on multiple occasions because it wasn't really clear. While The Darkness is a video game franchise may be forgotten in time, it's important to note that unlike other titles in this series on my channel, it's by no means forgotten as a whole. The Darkness continues to be a really strong brand in the comic book world, and I highly recommend that you order a few issues to check it out.
I personally bought the Darkness Anniversary Collection and thought it was fantastic. It was really awesome to see a new character that I've come to appreciate and enjoy in Jackie Estacado and The Darkness team up and fight against Batman and Superman. Just an awesome book, and I very much recommend it.
Well, that's all for today, YouTube. Take care, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video. And be sure to like and subscribe for more content.